So what we're going to go through in this video is how to back up your enterprise PDM vault. And this is a snapshot backup that we're going to take. It's not a scheduled backup. And the purpose of this is anytime you're going to be performing some kind of maintenance or an upgrade to your vault, it's good to take a snapshot backup because it's a quick way to recover your information to restore your vault in case of an issue, versus having to restore the entire server from its archives. So there's three key components to this. One's the SQL database, the other is the archive data, and lastly it's the archive server settings. And what we'll do is we'll go over to the archive data folder. I'll just point that out real quick. And on my computer, it's in the C location, program files, and then I have SolidWorks Enterprise PDM and data. And these folders here are the archives of my vaults. I have those two vaults that exist on my server computer here. Now, these other files are actually backups of my archive server settings and databases inside of SQL. There's this general Kinesio Master DB, and then those two vaults, their databases. So I typically, for a snapshot, will put them in here and then take this entire folder and just create an archive of that, zip it up. Now, what you want to consider before you're doing this is you want to do this when there's some kind of a downtime. No users are accessing the vault, so they're not changing information when you're performing the backup. So it's either in the evening or you're just telling people to stay out of the vault. You can even set the configuration up so that people cannot get into the vault. The other thing to consider is you may want to ask everybody to check in their information on their local cache, so that information gets backed up as well. This is only backing up what's on the server already. So if people have stuff checked out and they've made changes and haven't checked it in, they would lose that. They wouldn't have that information backed up. So it's just something to consider. Not necessarily a problem. That's not going to, you know, if there was a problem with an upgrade, it's not going to affect the local client cache. But I think it's a good idea just to get that backup anyway. So let's take a look at the archive server settings now. So I'm going to go over here. You can see it says archive server configuration. That's what we're typically looking for. So that's located under programs, SolidWorks Enterprise PDM, archive server configuration is what you're looking for. And we go in here and we expand this out. Now, for some reason, you try to do that and it doesn't open it up. It means it's been opened up previously. It's down here. So we'll just go to right mouse click and open, and it brings it back up on the screen. All right, so I'm going to navigate down here to archives, and I see my two vault archive locations. You can see it says database server, description, database name. If I go to properties, I also can see some of the path information in here as well. So it gives me some indication of where the files are. It gives me a general idea here. So that may help in determining where that folder is. So to get my archive server settings, tools, backup settings, I have on here include all vaults, so I don't have to check off specific ones. It is on mine, it's set up on a schedule as well, but what I'm going to do is I'm just going to pick the location of where it's going to go. It's already got the default in there, and just launch backup. Now, you may want to put a password on yours. I'm not putting it on mine. So that just gave me the latest update on that. Now, this doesn't change often, so if you didn't get the archive server settings, it may not be a big deal, but I think it's a good practice just to capture that in your backup. It's very quick. You can see it just did that very fast. Now it's time to go over to SQL. You want to make sure you have your SQL information, your SA password, your SA username if it's something other than SA. Here I got my login. You want to know what the authentication type is and all that information so you can access your database information. And then you want to get your backups. So there's this one general one here, this Kinesio Master DB. Every vault has that. And you want to go in here and perform a task. Go to backup. Backup type is going to be full. It tells me the database. You want to pick the location. I recommend using the location where you're putting your archives. So it's just going in one spot, and we can zip that up later. Take a look at the options. I have it pinned here. I'm going to say overwrite all. So it's just creating a completely new backup. And we'll OK that. Should go pretty quickly. That's a small database. Again, tasks, backup. It's on full, overwrite. That one will take a little bit longer. And then the name may not match exactly as what your vault name is. You see here I have PDMWE and then 2D to 3D vault. So sometimes EPDM will rename that in the creation process. So again, tasks, backup. We'll okay that. So I've got my database information backed up. I have my other information, my archive server settings, and then I have all these pieces here, my archives. Those are the physical files. At this point, all I need to do is set that aside here and just say add that to this. And it'll take some time to create that archive, but it gives me a backup or an archive of that information. And that's it.